and welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Darpan Kaur and I'm an oral and maxillofacial surgeon. In today's video, let's talk about when a wisdom tooth extraction is desired and when it's not. But before we move on, please make sure you subscribe to my channel for more content on medicine and healthcare. It is important to understand that as human beings have evolved and our dietary habits have changed, the shapes and sizes of our jaws and teeth have also undergone modification. Our jaws have gotten smaller, leading to less space for accommodation of all our teeth. This often causes the last teeth in our jaws to form, the wisdom teeth, to erupt in aberrant positions and sometimes to not erupt at all, a condition known as tooth impaction. Your dentist will consider removing your wisdom tooth under the following circumstances. The first is dental cavities, which can no longer benefit from restorations. The structure of the wisdom tooth can be quite complex because of which they seldom benefit from root canals. And since they don't play much of a role in chewing, removing them is often the preferred way to go. Second, infection. Infections can be characterized by the presence of pus and or fever. Dental x-rays play a significant role in diagnosing dental infections. Third, it is damaging the tooth in front of it or the surrounding tissues. Fourth, formation of a cyst. Wisdom teeth that do not fully erupt in the oral cavity are notoriously known to be associated with cyst formation. Of course, a lot of factors play a role in cyst formation, but it is still a concern worth considering. Persistent pain of unknown origins in the jaws can also be traced back to wisdom teeth that are not fully erupted in the oral cavity. This is because these wisdom teeth often travel close to a nerve canal, which can end up triggering pain. Wisdom teeth can also be recommended for removal before fabrication of a jaw, orthodontic treatment, treatment of a fractured jaw, or before radiation treatment. There is a certain condition called perichoronitis where the tissue overlying the partially erupted wisdom tooth can get inflamed, causing severe pain which may or may not radiate to other parts of your face, cause swelling, fever, or lead to infection. The guidelines given by the National Institute for Clinical Excellence, commonly known as the NICE guidelines, suggest that precautionary removal of wisdom teeth not associated with any disease should be discontinued. And second, that one episode of perichoronitis is not good enough reason to extract the wisdom tooth unless the symptoms were particularly severe. Second or subsequent episodes, however, are considered to be an appropriate indication for removal. There is a lot of controversy surrounding wisdom teeth and whether or not they should be extracted. I hope the contents of this video can help you make informed decisions. Don't forget to like and share this video and please subscribe for more content on medicine and healthcare. See you next time.